Right. So let us now come to the Mendeley reference manager, which means we need to look at Mendeley and how Mendeley can be used and how you researchers can be benefited by using some features of Mendeley, which will really help you in your throughout your research career. Right. So first, let us understand what Mendeley actually is. So Mendeley is a free reference manager, right? Along with that, Mendeley is also an academic social networking platform. Mendeley helps you organize your research and collaborate with others online. And it also helps you discover the latest research. So Mendeley has a repository of lot of research data that can be freely accessed. And all that data has DOIs and they are fully citable. Mendeley also helps you find career opportunities along with funding opportunities. Basically subject wise funding opportunities from across the globe. So how you can use Mendeley is basically, it's an open source software. So all of you can simply log on to www.mendeley.com. Then you can create a free account for yourself. If you have already registered on the ScienceDirect or Scopus platform, you can use the same login credentials to log into Mendeley. But make sure that you update your profile. Then you need to install the Mendeley desktop software and then install the MS Word plugin and web importer. Now I know that these are some of the steps that you need to follow and you might not recall all of them altogether. What I will do is that I will share a PPT with all the participants on how to use download Mendeley and how to install Mendeley and start using it. So don't worry. We will share that information with everyone. Okay, so now let us go back to the screen sharing, and I will just start sharing my screen again so that you are able to visualize my screen now from here, right? So what do we see here? What I want to show you is how you can go and log on to Mendeley. So if I just click on www.mendeley.com, it takes me to this particular homepage, right? Now, since I was already logged on to the ScienceDirect platform, it automatically logged me into Mendeley. This actually tells you that these platforms, ScienceDirect, Scopus, Mendeley, they are all connected because they are all Elsevier tools, right? So Elsevier has one login ID password, which you can use to access all the platforms, provided you have subscription to that content. Except for Mendeley, which is free of cost, right? So now that you have entered the platform, you can check your profile by just clicking here on your name. It will take you to your profile. You can complete your profile, right? If you are entering on Mendeley for the first time, it will ask you in the homepage to create a free profile. So you create a free profile for yourself. Now, when you come to this page, what do you see? So basically, you see that it looks more like a social networking platform. So you see there are people that have been recommended to you to add to your network. And as you go down, you see that whoever has posted, if he is your follower or you are his follower, you can actually see what he has posted, right? So see, this person has posted my research paper. This is what I was telling you. You should promote your paper. And now this person has posted it in a group. And see, it will get so much visibility. People will now be, you know, interested to go and see and look at his paper, right? And this is really something which I think all of you should do, right? So this comes under feed, this particular section. Next is the library. So when I talk about library, we also talked about Mendeley software. So the library is actually created on the Mendeley software. And since all the data on Mendeley is saved on a cloud, it is replicated on this platform. So if I click on library, it will show me my entire library that I have created on the software. And I can actually see it right here, right? So this is my entire library. So this is like a virtual drive, like a Google Drive, where you can actually see all these links. Next is suggest. So as I said, that Mendeley, ScienceDirect, Scopus, they are all interlinked. What happens when this interlink is there? So Mendeley can actually see what you are searching on Scopus. Mendeley can see what you are downloading from ScienceDirect, and Mendeley can also read what you have saved on Mendeley. So on the basis of that, Mendeley can actually suggest you some articles from its own repository, from research data, which are maybe of interest to you. So you can actually download those articles directly from the suggest option. Then we have groups. So in groups, what you can do, you can create groups. So basically, you can each person can create up to 5 groups, and each group can have up to 25 people. So basically, in those groups, you can share full text articles with each other, right? So that is the advantage of having private groups. Now you also see on the left hand side, you will see a section called groups. So these are all the open groups that I have added, including all the private groups. So there may be an open group which let's say is talking about a broad topic, and you see that the participants in that group are high impact authors and people that you follow or you want to join. So you can also be a part of that group and part of that discussion. But when you send a request to join that group, the administrator of that group may want to see who you are. So they don't want spammers to join that group because it's a group discussing academics. So they would want to see who you are. That is why your Mendeley profile is very important. So make sure that your profile is updated and correct. Next is data sets. So if I go to data sets, I will see that there is a lot of data that is freely available on the Mendeley platform. And this has been submitted by most of the researchers, right? So I told you that the green open access articles can later be shared on platforms, open access platforms. This is one such platform on Mendeley data. If I simply type a keyword here, let's say COVID, and I search, it gives me so many data like documents, data sets, images, videos, text, models. So whatever you need, you can simply go there. Let's say I click on video, and this is a video. I can click here, I can cite this video, I can save this to Mendeley, and I can do much, much more. So there is a lot of information that is available on Mendeley, which you can download. Next is careers. So if some of you are looking for job options across academic institutes, for postdoctoral PDF courses, for SRF, JRF, if you need any opportunities for research fellow across the world, you can actually search on this particular platform, right? So please explore it yourself. You will get a lot of information. But the tab that I want to really show you is the funding tab. So if I click on Mendeley funding, I can actually get information on funding agencies that are currently funding research in different countries, right? So if I want to see, let's say I go to browse funders, and now I want to see which are the funding agencies in Pakistan. So I click on Pakistan, and see right now there is one funding agency that has one opportunity which is mentioned under Higher Education Commission. So you can simply go, these are all the live opportunities, you can go click here and find out what kind of funding information is available. However, if you wish to look for more opportunities subject area wise, irrespective of the funding agency, what you can do is you can go online and you can click here on view all research areas and then choose from your subject area from within all these subject categories, right? So let's say I am interested in physics. Under physics, there are a lot of subcategories. So let's say I am interested in atomic and molecular physics. So I click here, I say results, right? And I get 78 funding opportunities. Now, first thing you need to know is whether you as Pakistani citizens are applicable to apply in these fundings or not, because most of the times the nationalities are mentioned. So all you need to do is go on the right hand side, left hand side, click on country of citizenship, and you can mention your country, and then see that out of them there are 17 opportunities where Pakistani citizens can apply for these fundings, right? So you have applied one filter. Next, there is another filter which is applicant type. So some of the fundings is usually only for graduate students, postgraduate students, some maybe only for women, that only women can apply in those. So all those categories are mentioned here very clearly, right? Whichever category you fall into, you can just choose that. So let's say I want to go for graduate students. Now there are three opportunities that are available, right? And you can see this on your screen. So what more information you can get is the name of the funding agency. This is right here, right? This is the name of the funding agency. Then you have the name of the topic. So this is the topic name. This is the deadline. So it is still ongoing. They have not mentioned any deadline as such. If the deadline is mentioned, then the date will be given. And here you will be able to see how many days are left to apply. Then amount, again, not specified. Probably this is not applicable. But you see here down below, amounts are usually specified. What kind of funding it is, right? And then what type of funding this is? This is fellowships. So you see this type. Then there is research and publications. There may be other funding types like prizes, awards. So all those things will be mentioned right here. Now, if you go into a particular funding, you will be able to find other information about that particular topic, right? The eligibility. And if the contact details are given, they will be mentioned here. So for this particular topic, they have not mentioned any funding, the contact details. So it's not available here, right? So this is everything that you can do on the Mendeley web version, right? Now let us go to the Mendeley software and see how this. So software looks like this, right? And when you open the Mendeley software, first time it will open like this, right? And if you are using Mendeley for the first time, this particular section will be blank because you haven't saved any document. If you wish to save any document, you need to drag and drop. So what you can do is you can basically drag a PDF item from your screen and drop it here. So on your Mendeley platform, you can save PDFs, you can save references, and basically you can save anything, but it will only read references and PDFs, right? So if you see an icon like this on your screen, this is a PDF icon. If you see no icon, it means it's just a reference. And if you see this download link, it means that the link to download the full text is available, but I have not saved it. So it remains as a reference on my screen. Now, what you can do, how you can arrange your library is that by creating folders. So from here, you can create folders, right? And let's say I have created project one, project two, whatever folders I want. And then I can drag and drop my articles onto these folders. So let's say my articles are here. I can simply drag and drop it to this folder. So it gets arranged in my particular folder. Let's say there is a folder on your desktop. There are 100 articles in those folder. And you want to transfer all those 100 articles to a folder which is named the same on Mendeley. So what you do is you create a folder name. Let's say project one. You open it. You minimize your window. And then you drag and drop that folder here. So all the articles in that folder will be copied directly to this folder on Mendeley. So this is how Mendeley can help you arrange your library. And moreover, if you need information on how good your library is, because we read that the editors will want to look at the time ranges of your citation. And if you want to know that your library has enough articles from dating back, which are back files, or latest articles, what you can do is simply click on all documents and then you can click or here. So this can sort this on the basis of year, right? And see, I have the earliest article from 1823. So it is right here, right? So you will get a lot of information on Mendeley about how to organize your particular library. Next, you remember I asked you that we need to install a few things. So that installation can be done from tools. So you can simply go to tools and install Web Importer and install MS Word plugin. You will also see an option to get Mendeley site. Now this is a beta version that is currently running and under trial. So once it gets officially, it comes out, it will be integrated into the software. But for now, you can install the Web Importer and install the MS Word plugin for your reference, right? Let us open a document and show you how a document actually looks like. So let's say I open this document, right? So it will open up like this. Now on this page, you see there are a lot of highlighting and notes that has been done. Now you might be thinking how you can do this. So basically on top you see there is an icon which says highlight. So I click here and I highlight this particular section. And now I want to put a note on it. So I can simply put my note here, right? And I save it like this. Now this is particularly useful when there are multiple people involved in working on one particular article and they would want to share updates with each other or share these links with each other. So simply you can do this. This will remain saved like this on this particular platform. Once you are done with all the highlighting, you can share it in that group. So you see all the groups are mentioned here. So in that private group where you have all the concerned people, you can simply click on this article, drag and drop it to that group. It will straight away go to that group. All the members of this group will get a notification that an article has been added by so and so person. And then they can open this group article and then find out the notes from here. On the left, right hand side, there is a section called notes. So you simply click here. This opens all the notes on this page, right? And if I want to go to my particular section, I will click here and it takes me to my section. Then I can put my note on top of this, right? My feedback, and again, it remains saved like this. The best part about Mendeley is when you are working simultaneously on one paper, each user is automatically assigned a particular color. So it is easy from the color coding to understand who has commented on what particular section, right? So this is how you are going to do research in groups on Mendeley. Now remember, we asked you to install web importer and Word plugin. Now let us see how this web importer and plugin works. So let's say you are on the ScienceDirect platform. Now you can be on any platform, right? Doesn't matter. You can be on ScienceDirect, on IEEE, on Springer, or even on sometimes on Google. However, I do not recommend that you save articles from Google. So what you can do, you can simply go here, you can put in a few keywords. Let's say I just put in a few keywords, random keywords. And now there are a lot of articles that I'm going to see that come up on the search results. So first, what you're going to see, you're going to see all the top journals that are for this particular topic that you have mentioned. So you can see them here. Right, you can go to view all, then you see all the articles here, right? So you can sort the articles on the basis of relevance and date. So if you need older articles, click on date and it will sort it accordingly, right? You can also use your filters on the left hand side, from where you can easily filter out. If you need an article from 1997, you can click here, it will give you only those articles, right? Now, there are so much information on this page. Now, from this page, I wish to transfer two documents to Mendeley. How am I going to do that? So, if I have Mendeley, I will simply go to this page. You see this small icon on top just beside your browser? This is the Mendeley plugin. So, I click on this Mendeley plugin. It opens a side window. And now, this window will have all the articles that are listed on this particular page, including the website. So if you wish to cite the website, you can still click on Mendeley and copy this reference from here directly to Mendeley. And it is as simple as clicking any article that you want to save and clicking add. If you have access to PDF, so if it doesn't have access to PDF, it will say PDF not found. If there is access to PDF, you will see PDF okay, right? So once you do this, you click on add, and this takes you straight away to Mendeley. Now, when you go on Mendeley software, you will find that article here under recently added. So from here, then you can transfer this article to any folder you want, right? So this again helps you in properly organizing your entire research data, and it will make it easier for you to cite your articles later on. So now that you have learned on how to save articles from Mendeley to this particular platform, I hope you are able to see my screen, right? Right. Okay. Right. So now what next you need to do is you need to start writing and cite, right? Now on Mendeley, you can actually find a lot of information on how to do this and do this very easily. So if I open a blank Microsoft Word window, right? This technology that is used on Mendeley is called cite while you write. That means you do not have to make any pre-arrangements. The only pre-arrangement you need is all documents are saved on Mendeley, either the PDFs or the references. So what you need to do, you just start writing your thesis or article or anything that you are writing. And now you need to insert a citation right here where my cursor is. So how am I going to do it? I will go to references, this section here. I will click on insert citation. So you see this Mendeley Cite-O-Matic. This is the Microsoft Word plugin which we installed under tools, right? So now I want to insert a citation. So I click on insert citation. I go to Mendeley, and since I have saved all the articles on Mendeley, it becomes easy for me to understand where my article is. So I can simply go to that folder. This is the article that I want to cite, right? So I click on this article and I say cite. Can you see cite on top? So I simply click on cite. Now this citation has been created. Now we want to know which format is this in. So you see on top there is a style box. If you click on this style box, this is in Vancouver style at the moment. I want to change it to APA style. So this is the APA style and this is the 6th edition. So I click here, it changes to APA style, right? And now I continue writing. Now I wish to include two citations together. What happens when we include two citations together? They are merged. And every format has a merging style. But if you are using Mendeley, you need not remember everything. All you need to do is click on insert citation, go to Mendeley, choose the two articles that you need to cite, and you say cite again on top. Both the articles are now cited. Now you can make as many changes, as many citations. I have done 3. You can do 100, 200, 500, as many as you want, right? Once you are done doing this, right, just put your cursor where you want to insert your bibliography, right? Now here, just go on top and click on insert bibliography here. As soon as you click, your entire bibliography is created right here. Okay, and this is in APA format. I want to change it to IEEE. I can click here and go to IEEE. Now you might be wondering, where do you get these names of citation styles? Again, the answer to that question is Guide for Authors. Go to Guide for Authors, under Abstract and Indexing, they will mention the name of the citation style. If they don't mention the name, you can always write to the editor asking for the name of the Mendeley citation style, right? Now, again, in your entire career, if you ask your seniors also, they might have come across 2, 5, 10, not more than 10 citation styles. You know, that's just an average number that I'm telling you. But again, there are many citation styles that are available, right? On Mendeley, we have a repository of more than 7,500 citation styles that you can work with. All you need to know is the name of the citation style. So once this is done, let's say now this is in IEEE format. Now there are some things that you can do on Mendeley also. For example, I want to insert page number or figure number. How do I do that? So I click on that citation which I need to edit. And on top, now I see this insert citation has become edit citation. So I click on edit citation and I click on the citation that I want to edit. So I click here and from this drop down here on the left hand side, I can insert anything. I can insert page number, folio, anything. So let's say I want to insert page number 2 and I say OK. So see, this has inserted page number 2 and your citation has become more correct. Now, what if you need to delete a citation? So what if the reviewer tells you or your friend tells you that you need to remove citation number 1? What will happen if you remove citation number 1? This 2 will become 1, 3 will become 2, here also and here also. If you have done this manually, you need to edit all the numbers manually one by one, which again, some of you might be still doing, right? If you are using Mendeley, simply click beside the citation you want to delete, press backspace twice, this article gets deleted, this citation gets deleted, and from the box above, you click on refresh. And automatically, 3 will become 2 and 2 will become 1. Similarly, you can add a citation anywhere. Now, if I want to re-add the citation right here in the beginning, I will go to Mendeley, I will click on that particular citation and I will say cite. Now you see that citation has been created. And again, the numbers have reshuffled. One became 2 and 2 became 3, right? According to the format. So you don't need to worry about the format. All you need to worry about is having the right citations on your Mendeley library, right? And this library, let's say you can't find your citation style from this drop-down, go to more styles. Once you go to more styles, you can actually start first look under installed list, whether that citation style is installed. And if you see this icon, which is update available, do update your styles because they keep on updating. If you can't find it under installed list, go to get more styles and just type, start typing, and it will keep showing you of options, right? And then from here, if you find the correct one, you simply click here and click on install. It will directly install that particular citation style, and then you can find it here under install list and say use your files. Now again, there is something which is very important. Some of your institutes or some of you authors do collaborate with researchers across the globe, and there may be cases where the language of the article is not English. So it may be a different language. You can still use Mendeley to cite your articles in that language. So if you see here, there is a drop down which says African, Arabic. So there are close to 140 languages that are mentioned here. Whichever language you wish to choose, let's say Arabic, and I say done. Whatever needs to be changed to Arabic has already changed. So you don't need to rely because everything will not change to Arabic. Whatever needs to be changed has changed, right? Even if I go to APA, you see only those portions that need to be changed have changed. Rest, everything else remains as it is. So my request to all of you is use Mendeley. It is really going to help you, explore the entire, this field of citations and bibliography. And you can save a lot of time on your reference management by using Mendeley. And I would like to reconfirm this. Mendeley is free to use. So all of you can use Mendeley. There is no charge of using Mendeley, and you can easily become more efficient. It can increase your research efficiency. So with that, what I want to do now is I will just share my screen again. For the last few slides that I wish to discuss with you. We have already discussed about today, what from session one, we have discussed about how to write a good manuscript, how to prepare yourself before you start writing, what elements you need to collect, how you should write a good article. I think if you can incorporate all of these things, you can become more confident in research writing, because I see there are a lot of questions related to research writing and efficiency. I think if you can use this, and my recommendation to all of you, please visit Elsevier Researcher Academy. It's a free portal. There are free courses. You can take up these courses and become Elsevier certified. With that, I would like to end by saying that please, stay safe from this pandemic that is happening. May God bless our path with knowledge and light that will help us to enlighten our heart. Wishing all of you a very happy Ramadan. I hope this session was useful, and we look forward to your feedback for the session.